everybody. My name is J.S. Matthews, and welcome back to the second episode of Writing and Roleplaying. And in this episode, we're going to be taking a break from the crafting, and we're going to be jumping into, well, basically some writing and some roleplaying. We're going to work on today a little technique I have whenever I have writer's block, and hopefully this will be helpful for you both as a writer, or perhaps as a DM, and even as a roleplayer. So without further ado, let's go ahead and just jump right on in. Now, I've found that when I am struggling with writer's block, or if I can't come up with a good encounter for my tabletop role-playing games, something good to do is to engage my senses, mainly sight and sound. Do you notice how most of your senses are actually very much linked, and how things that you touch and taste are actually linked? You can look at something and know that that is how that is going to taste, right? The texture of it, or how it is going to feel. Something that's interesting is when you hear something, usually you will see something because of what you are hearing. For instance, let's use a little example here. I'm going to play something for you, and you tell me what you see when you hear this. Of course, we all know what we see when we hear that. When we hear that music, we see the scroll from Star Wars. It's ingrained in us. If you've seen those movies, that is what you see when you hear that music. Let's try another one. What do you see when you hear this? Hopefully, if you've seen the Fellowship of the Ring, you saw Hobbiton. You saw the hobbits digging in their, you know, in their gardens, and you saw Frodo maybe running up to Gandalf. But you have these images in your brain because of the music that you heard when that was occurring. And so something I want to do, though, with you guys today is, what if you hear something that you haven't really heard before? What images come to mind? So we're going to start there. I'm going to play some music for us here, and I want you to start thinking about what you are seeing when you hear it. Don't just be thinking about hearing. Be thinking about what you are seeing. Think about your vision. And on top of that, be thinking about what you are feeling. What sort of emotions come to mind when you hear this music? So as this is going, ask yourself those questions and see what you come up with. Okay, so what did you see listening to that music? What did you feel? Usually when I hear this music, I think a little bit of sadness, something scary even, or dangerous, or maybe not in the, I mean, it's not an action scene. Perhaps it's before or after an action scene. Perhaps what you saw were the remnants of a battle, or maybe a ship sailing through dangerous waters, or maybe even a duel, or before the duel between two foes. Now, what you have in your head, keep that, write it down. And the next step then is to go back to the music and start asking yourself these next five questions. When is this happening? Where is this happening? Who is involved? Why is this happening, or why did it happen? And what is actually happening. Let's take our first example there. The remnants of a battle. Maybe this was, you know, some sort of battle that was occurring, and we're going to take my five questions here and we're going to answer them. So first of all, when? Well, my initial feeling is the Civil War, almost like a Western feel to it. And maybe that's because I actually know where the song comes from, but that is what it makes me think about. But maybe it's not the Civil War, the American Civil War. Maybe it's just a Civil War. Maybe it's in a fantasy world of your own creation, or who knows? It doesn't have to be real. It can be whatever you want it to be. Now, where is this taking place? In my mind, the first thing that comes to my mind is a forest. You hear sort of like the creaking of wood, right? That was actually where the idea of perhaps a ship in dangerous waters came from or something like that. You hear that sort of like creaking in the background of the music, and it just made me think of like the trees in the forest just creaking. Have you ever been in a forest when it's really quiet? You can hear the forest. Now the who. Who is our character in this scene? Well, I was picturing a soldier. A soldier who survived this battle walking through the battlefield, or the leftovers of it, the aftermath. And maybe why did this occur? Well, I mean, the Civil War is occurring because, for most reasons why wars occur, power. People in power wanted more, and this man was caught up in it. Maybe he was proud to serve, but now that he sees the bodies of his friends and you know, he was forced to kill other people, maybe he doesn't feel so strongly about that anymore. So what is exactly happening? Well, let's just give a quick little outline. This is the aftermath of a battle. The bodies of friends and foes are strewn about. Sadness is all around, and the smell of death lingers. Now, here's the thing. You could keep going with this. You could expand your story here, and I think you'd be fine. I could go off on this forever. Why did this battle happen? You know, I know it said power, but how did this battle end up occurring where it did in this forest? Maybe there's something else going on there. Maybe this was between two sides in a civil war, and maybe his brother or family member is on the other side, maybe his father, and he's searching to see if maybe his father's body is out there, his brother's body is out there. I mean, who knows? So there's a lot you could do with this, but let's go ahead and add another wrinkle to our sound effects. Let me know if this changes what you see. Okay, as you can tell, we added in some rain effects, and we have some thunder in the background. So, of course, the when hasn't changed, and the who has not changed. But maybe the where has. It's a forest, but now it's during a rainstorm. And maybe this is a little bit after the battle. I mean, in my first idea, maybe it was just kind of a couple hours after. Maybe this is a day or two. And it's still a surviving, soldier. But let's take a look at the what now. The aftermath of a battle amidst a rainstorm. The bodies of friends and foes are strewn about. Blood and water pool together in the mud, washing away the stains of war. It is a scene of pure sadness. And so now our scene has started to change. Now we really feel that heavy, melancholy, sad feeling of the rain and the music and this image that is going through our head. But let's add one more wrinkle to our sound effects. Thank you. So I added in some different sound effects there to change what we were seeing. So instead of being in a forest, obviously the sounds we're hearing are the sounds of a town. Probably the creaking of doors opening, people talking, but they're not talking very loudly. It's pretty quiet. So this kind of change is what I'm seeing. So instead of it being a surviving soldier, now it's many. It's many soldiers marching through this town quietly through the rain. They're not marching proudly, but sadly, most likely they're the losers of this battle, or whoever remained of the losers of this battle, marching, retreating through the rain. And so this changes the image of what we're seeing. So let's take a look at this newer story. An army retreats after a battle amidst a rainstorm. They walk slowly, their eyes empty, yet their minds are filled with memories of the horrific battle. They see the bodies of friends and foes strewn about in the back of their minds, blood and water pooling together in the mud and washing away the stains of war, a war that still continues. So you see, now we have a different scene. This is not just one person searching through a battlefield. Now we have a different one. And we have many people marching through the streets. You could even mention the people looking out the windows, or maybe this is a town they've occupied. Maybe this is an enemy town that they've occupied and now they're retreating from. Or maybe this is one of their own towns and they're retreating through it. They've lost the battle for this town. Now people are worrying, do they need to pack up their things and run? What is the invading army going to do to them? And now you see, just by using a few simple sound effects, we can create an entire scene and an entire story. Now here's the thing. This is really going to help you with writer's block if you're a writer. But if you're a DM, let's say you're struggling with what you want for an encounter. Well, guess what? This would make a great encounter. Your players arrive at a town and they see the survivors of this battle just sort of limping through the town. Maybe they support this side. Maybe they don't. Maybe this is like, perhaps one of the old Clint Eastwood movies where, these are very mercenary-like players and they want nothing to do with this war and they're just trying to make money off of it. War creates a lot of problems and those problems need to be solved by somebody. So maybe that could be your players. Maybe this could be a little bit more of a gray mercenary-like playthrough. And that can be your very first encounter with this war-torn region, is them walking into this town and seeing the horrific aftermath of this battle. Now that we've spent some time fiddling with our sound, listening, and trying to see what we hear, now we're going to flip things around. Now, I'm going to show you an image. And I want you to think about what you feel when you see this image. And if you want to, maybe think about what you're hearing. What are some things that you hear? And maybe not necessarily music, but what sounds would you hear if you were in this image? Let's go ahead and take a look at it. Okay. Now, I don't know exactly what you saw, but I'm going to share with you what I see when I see this image. Now, this one, I typed in keywords, scary docks. That was all I did, and I found this on artstation.com, and it fit, it just looked cool, just stood out to me, and so I just decided, you know what, that's what I'm going to use. Now, when I look at this image, I notice a few things initially. First of all, what am I feeling? Well, dread. It's a very dark atmosphere, right? Very heavy. The clouds are above you. Everything is dark. This is an old fishing village. You can tell perhaps it's just an old fishing village, or maybe we are, during this time where it is older. And you can see the body hanging at the top left. That was one of the first things that drew my eye, the silhouette of a body, as well as the door that's partially opened at the bottom there. And those two things stood out to me. I can hear the soft waves in the background, maybe some thunder and lightning off in the distance, but it hasn't arrived yet. A storm is coming, but it's not there yet. And, I can hear the seagulls and the wind. And that's about it. And that's what it does for sounds and kind of what I'm feeling. But let's go back to our set of questions. And let's ask them about this image. When is this happening? Where is it happening? Who's involved? Why is it happening? And what exactly is occurring? So let's start with the when. Well, obviously, I could pick more of a modern day. Maybe they're in just an older village, but I want this to be sort of like maybe Victorian era is kind of what I was picturing. That was my first feeling. I don't know why what gave me that, but I always thought muskets are kind of cool. And, you know, it's kind of like a cool little transition between older, you know, medieval technology and then, of course, the newer technologies. And so we'll stick with that. Now, the where, I don't know. I really don't. I could see this being in many places, but, you know, maybe this is on the coast of Northeast North America. And so we have this fishing village, right? And who's involved? Well, we have the man who's hanging. But this open door really gave me an idea. The door is open because the man who hung him has left. So we have the who's involved. And the why. Well, our previous story was about maybe a battle lost, or perhaps a son searching for the body of his father in this, you know, the mess of this battle. And so I was thinking, well, maybe this person knows who killed his father, or who killed his brother during that battle. And years later, he tracks him down to this village, and he finds out he lives in this little fishing hut at the edge of town, and he comes and he finds the man, and they fight, and he wraps a rope around his neck and kicks him out of this upper window. Maybe there's a little opening here. You can't really see it. It's dark, but that's how I imagine it. And he watches as the man who killed his brother or his father dangles and slowly strangles, but decides he can't fully watch it, so he walks out, leaving the door ajar, not sure if his actions of revenge are truly satiating that desire for justice. And all he hears as he's walking away is the seagulls and the distant rumble of thunder, just like on that night when he found the body of his father or his brother, and the soft lapping of the waves and the seagulls cry. But he also hears something else, the creaking and the straining of wood and rope as the man finally stops his struggles and gives in to the cold hands of death. Now, I think that's a pretty cool sounding story. I could expand that. I could come up with some better reasons why, but that is a cool scene, and that is a cool idea and a cool story. And again, if you're an author, start there. Maybe this is the end of your story. How do you get there? That's your next question. How do you get there? Work your way backwards. This is the end of your story, but why does one man end up killing another? Why? Ask yourself those questions. The other thing is, if you're a DM, this is a cool scene for an encounter, or maybe a murder mystery. Who knows? Maybe they have to solve why this man was killed. Maybe he was a really nice man. Everybody around the village loved him. But then you start uncovering that before he came to this village, maybe he was a war criminal. He committed horrible, terrible deeds. And the man who killed him was the descendant of one of those men or women who whose lives he ruined during the war. Something like that. And that's, again, that's a great little quest, little side quest for your characters to go on. Or you can make it a little more personal. Make it one of the characters' relations or something like that. Or maybe it is, you could make it one of the shop owners the characters frequently visit, or an NPC they're really good friends with. Have them die and have them solve it, but find out that this NPC may not have been as good as they thought they were, at least they were before. And let the players decide, did this person deserve redemption? You know, were they redeemed? Or did this change their perception of this person? Are they forever tainted? You know, is there an idea of redemption? Can forgiveness be justice? That is a cool way to get your players to think, and leave it up to them. Let their characters decide. Now, we're going to try one more thing here, just because I want you to kind of see and hear this. And we're going to actually combine everything together, and we're going to see how this scene plays out.
Thank you.
All right. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this little technique that I was showing off. It's really helpful to me. If you watched this and enjoyed it, let me know what you think. If you're trying this out, let me know what you're trying. Share some of your links below to the images you're using or the sounds that you use. Maybe you have a soundtrack that you write to or that you play when you're working on the scenes for your tabletop role-playing game, what you want your players to be experiencing. Let me know in the comments what you do. What are your solutions to writing block as a writer or as a DM or, I mean, heck, even as a role player? This kind of stuff is great for role playing. I can look at an image and come up with a background for my character. Who is my character and why are they? Well, this kind of an image or anything else can really give you a great background for an NPC or for your own character, or for perhaps a character in your book. Anyways, hope you guys really enjoyed this episode. I had a great time making it. This is something I actually teach other teachers. I get to do this, and I share it with my students as well. But I think it's just a fun little exercise to do, and it's a good way to get your imagination going, and it's a good way to just kind of jumpstart some creativity. Anyways, if you enjoyed it, leave a like, maybe even subscribe. I got plenty of other writing and role-playing goodness coming your way. And let me know again if you got anything from this episode or what else you do to help with your writer's block. Anyways, I hope you all have a great day, and I will see you in the next episode of Writing and Role-Playing.